Hello and welcome to the Commander's Quarters. I'm your host, Mitch. Glad to have you here. Now, usually on the show, we build fun and inexpensive focused commander decks on a $25 budget. But today we're going to be doing something a little different. Recently, a lot of people have asked me what exactly a focus deck is. In the intros, I say that a focus deck is more tuned than a casual deck, but not quite to the level of a competitive or optimized deck. So in order to fully define a focus deck, I need to define each and every single tier. So I figured that the easiest and most thorough way to answer this question is to do an episode where I go through each and every single one of the tiers and what those tiers mean to me. A quick reminder that any prices you see on this show are powered by our sponsor, TCG Player. Before we get started today, though, make sure you go check out our new classic pink playmat and Commander's Quarters t-shirts on thecommanderscquarters.com. And thank you to everyone who's already purchased our merchandise. It really does help support the channel. Also, make sure that you subscribe to the channel and click that little bell notification icon so that you can stay up to date on the latest Commander's Quarters episodes. Before we get into defining the tiers, I want to give a quick disclaimer. The way that I break down these tiers is completely based off of my opinion. Other people and other content creators might have different ways to break down these tiers or have completely different tiers themselves. I didn't come up with these five tiers, and my interpretation of these tiers might be different from others. That doesn't mean that one person is right and other people are wrong. These things are completely subjective. Also, there is no inherent right or wrong way to build a deck, but we can categorize the way that people build them. So now that we're on the same page, let's go through the tiers. First up, let's start off at tier number 5, Jank. In my opinion, a Jank commander deck is a deck that has a purpose outside of winning. Some people build decks around funny tribal aspects, such as everyone sitting in chairs. So as you can see in the three photos, every single one of these characters is sitting in a chair. The decks don't really have any particular synergies, they just focus on making sure that every single one of their pictures includes a chair. Another style of a deck within this tier is a deck that's built around the lore of Magic. These kinds of decks want to tell a story, so they'll include specific cards that relate to that story. For example, with a deck that's based around the story of the Weatherlight, it might include some of these cards. These cards might not synergize with each other, but that's not the purpose of the deck. And a final style of deck that falls within this tier is an artist-inspired deck. These kinds of decks are specifically made to showcase the art of Magic. So if someone's favorite artist is Therese Nielsen, they might build an entire deck built around her cards. There are plenty of ways to build a Jank deck, but again, the one thing that they have in common is that they have a purpose outside of actually winning. So now that we've defined and given some examples of Jank decks, let's go on to the next tier. And that would be tier number 4, which is the casual tier. To me, a casual deck is a deck that wants to win, but it's not as tuned as it could be. So an example of a deck like this would be one that doesn't have a tuned strategy. Atraxa is an incredibly powerful commander, and there are plenty of different ways to build her. One of these ways is Super Friends, where you're building the entire deck around Planeswalkers and things that help Planeswalkers out, like Oath of Teferi. And another way is building around +1/+1 counters with things like Hardened Scales. These are both great ways to build an Atraxa deck, but they are separate strategies. If you're trying to do too many strategies at once, you're not building a focused deck. So in this situation, to make your deck more tuned, you need to pick one of these two strategies and stick with it. Another reason that a deck might be considered casual if there are easy and obvious improvements that can be made. For example, a deck might be running Manalith, which is the baseline mana rock that costs 3. Whereas it could easily swap in something like Vessel of Endless Rest, which does the exact same thing but has some additional utility. Or it could be running something like Cancel, which is the baseline 3 mana counterspell. And an easy improvement to that is to run something like Dissolve, which has a little more utility as well. And essentially, there's no difference in cost between these cards and the cards that they improved on. With just these simple adjustments, a deck can become more tuned. And finally, another reason that a deck might be considered casual is because it uses pet cards. My favorite card growing up was Sylvas Rogue Elemental. I played in a very casual environment and I love casting Sylvas and just swinging out with them. Now, as much as I want to include Sylvas in any of my green decks, I haven't yet. It just hasn't been good enough to make the cut in any deck that I built so far. If I were to force it into a deck where there are better options, I'd be making that deck into a casual deck and not a focused deck. There is absolutely nothing wrong with pet cards, and you can include in whatever cards you want into your deck. So if you're including a pet card just because you like that card and not because you think it'll help you win, it's going to be a more casual deck. Again, a casual commander deck is a deck that wants to win, but it's not as tuned as it could be. So now that we've defined and given some examples of a casual commander deck, let's go on to the next tier. And that would be tier number 3, which is the focus tier. Here at the Commander's Quarters, this is the tier that we build our decks at. A focus commander deck is a deck that is as tuned as possible within a budget. On this channel, there are plenty of examples of what a focus commander deck is. These decks revolve around a strategy and a way to win. With Arcades, you want to cast a ton of cheap defenders and then beat down your opponents with them. With Joyeray, you want to cast free or reduce cost artifacts and then storm off. And then with Selenia, you want to control the board, set your life total down low, and then swap it with others. Each of these has a specific strategy and a way they go about winning. But for more on how these focus decks are built, go check the deck techs out. The only limitation that stops a focus deck from being an optimized deck is budget. Commander's Quarters decks are built within a $25 budget, so there are certain cuts that we have to make because of that. For example, we're going to be running things like Warren Power Stone over Sol Ring simply because of the price. Essentially, Warren Power Stone does the exact same thing as Sol Ring, but in a less efficient way. It is over $3 cheaper though, so it's much easier for us to justify fitting in the budget. Another example would be something like Cloak and Dagger, which we're going to run over Lightning Greaves. Essentially, it's a worse version of Lightning Greaves that doesn't give haste and it costs more to equip. But we still want to use something to protect our commander, and it is nearly $7 cheaper. And finally, another example of a budget decision is going to be using Rocky Tar Pit over Bloodstained Mire. In pretty much every situation, Rocky Tar Pit is going to be a worse version of Bloodstained Mire. But the cost of just one Bloodstained Mire is more than the total of our entire deck. If all prices were equal, we would definitely play Bloodstained Mire over Rocky Tar Pit, but they aren't. So again, a focus deck is a deck that is as tuned as possible within its budget. But now that we've defined focus, let's go on to the next tier. And that's going to be tier number 2, which is optimized. In my opinion, an optimized commander deck is a deck with no budget restrictions, but with other limitations. So cost is never taken into account. If a card is better than another, they're going to include it no matter what the cost is. So if Vampiric Tutor is going to be one of the best tutors for the deck, it's going to include it even though it's $45. The same is true for Mana Crypt. If it's going to be one of the best mana rocks in the deck, it has to be included at $172. And even something like Gaia's Cradle at $353 needs to be included if it improves the deck. An optimized deck doesn't take price into account no matter what that price is. An optimized deck is just that, it's as optimized as it can be. If there's a card out there that would improve the deck, but it's not being added in because of cost, then it's not an optimized deck, it's a focus deck. Focus decks have budget restrictions and optimized decks don't. What optimized decks do have, though, are certain limitations that prevent them from being considered competitive decks. One of those limitations is commander selection. You can build an optimized deck around every commander, but not every commander can be competitive. For example, you could put thousands of dollars into a Yargle deck and make it as optimized as possible. But as much as you love Yargle, it's never going to be a competitive deck. The restriction is built into the commander itself. There are simply more powerful commanders that are more suited for the competitive environment. So as much as you might want Yargle to be a top-tier deck, it's never going to be. There's a finite amount of top-tier commanders, and if you're not building around one of them, then you're not building a competitive deck. And finally, there might be some playgroup limitations that prevent a deck from being considered competitive. Certain playgroups may not like or even allow the use of certain cards, even though they're legal in Commander. So cards like Armageddon, Smokestack, and Stasis might be banned in those playgroups. If your deck would be more competitive with a card, but you're choosing not to include it because of a playgroup limitation, then your deck is optimized and not competitive. Again, an optimized deck is a deck that's built to be as powerful as it can be, and it has no budget, but it has other limitations. So now that we've defined optimized decks, let's go to our last tier, and that's going to be tier number 1, which is competitive. In my opinion, a competitive Commander deck is a deck without any restrictions, and it's playing at the top tier. So these decks have no budget restrictions, but they're only going to be playing with the top commanders. So an example of a competitive deck these days might use something like Thrasios and Timna. But the list of top tier commanders can change with new cards coming in and new commanders that are created. What doesn't change though in the competitive format is that anything goes. Again, with this tier, there are no playgroup limitations. So comboing off on turn 1 or 2 with something like Flash and Protean Hulk is completely fine. There are no group bannings on certain cards or certain strategies. It's win at any cost and as fast as you can. Again, the definitions of competitive in every single one of these tiers in this video are completely based off of my opinion. There is no right or wrong when it comes to defining tiers, it's 100% subjective. So with that, the show is coming to a close, but I really want to hear about what you guys think about these tiers, so why don't you let me know in the comments below. When you're buying a deck or just individual cards, make sure to use our link in the description. Not only will you be getting great prices on TCG Player, but you're also going to be supporting this show because they sponsor us. And make sure that you follow us on social media so you can get some early hints on who the next commander just might be. Links to our social media accounts can be found in the description. Also in the description below is a link to the Commander's Quarters Patreon page, and I just want to say a quick thank you to the patrons who have subscribed so far. There are many benefits to being a patron for the Commander's Quarters, including being able to vote on future commanders for deck techs. There's even a general level tier where you get your own personalized deck tech dedicated to you. I truly couldn't do this without all of your support, so from the bottom of my heart, thank you. If you haven't already, make sure that you like and subscribe to the channel, and then check out some of our playlists on budget commander decks, commander excluded decks, and break the bank episodes. Also, check out some new content creators that we're featuring on our Creator's Quarters episodes. And with that, I'm out of here. Thanks again, and have a good one.